Okay. Good evening, students.
Good evening, ma'am.
In the last class, we were discussing about a characteristic property of light that is known as atmospheric refraction. Do you remember that topic?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What do you mean by atmospheric refraction, Aditya? Can you say what do you mean by atmospheric refraction?
When light gets dispersed by the atmosphere, because every layer has a different optical density.
Yes, it is the refraction of light caused by the atmosphere due to the varying optical density possessed by the different layers of the atmosphere is known as atmospheric refraction. We know that atmosphere have different layers like troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere. These different layers of atmosphere possess different optical density. So by the term, what do you mean by optical density? What do you mean by optical density, Anne Mary? What do you mean by optical density?
Of medium to refract.
Yes, it is the ability of a medium to refract light. Since different layers of atmosphere possess different optical density, the light is get refracted in random directions. So that is what is known as atmospheric refraction. And one of the practical application of atmospheric refraction is, what do you mean by that? It is the twinkling of stars. Twinkling of stars. The twinkling of stars is occurs due to atmospheric refraction. Then Adidev, can you say what do you mean by or how the stars twinkle? How does the stars twinkle? Yes.
The stars twinkle by everybody. Atmospheric refraction.
Very good. And how it is occurs?
When the light from the star enters the Earth's atmosphere, it refracts.
Refracts
many times and in random directions.
Yes, it is refracts many times and in random direction due to why it is happens. It is because of
varying optical density.
Yes, very good. It is because of varying optical density possessed by the different layers of atmosphere. So it is seems to be the star is seem to be move from its original position, and we are interpret this phenomenon as the twinkling of stars. Then the second application of the refraction of light that we are discussing in our class is advanced sunrise and delayed sunset. What do you mean by this advanced sunrise and delayed sunset? First of all, you must get an idea about during the actual sunrise and sunset, what about the position of the sun? Where is the sun located? Yes, Vishnupriya. During the sunrise and sunset, where is the position, the actual position of the sun? When we can say that, yes, if and only if the sun passes or sun crosses the horizon, then only we can say that the actual sunset occurs. So I will explain the same process. The next characteristic property of light is known as scattering. All of you write the heading. The next characteristic property of the light is known as scattering of light. Today we are going to discuss about the scattering of light. All of you write the heading. So the next topic that we are going to discuss is scattering of light. Have you heard about this term scattering? What is the word meaning of scattering? What do you mean by this term scattering? What do you mean by scattering? Yes. What is the meaning of this word scattering? Have you heard about spreading? So scattering means spread into various direction, or we can say driving off to various direction. That is what is mean by scattering, spreading or driving off to various direction, into different direction. So if a light is came from a point source, if it is spread into various direction or it is drive off to various direction, then we can say the scattering of light takes place. Then what do you mean by scattering? That is what is we are going to discuss. It is a phenomenon of change in the direction of propagation of light caused by the large number of particles present in the atmosphere is called scattering of light. This is the definition. First of all, you write the definition of scattering of light. After that, we can explain what you mean by scattering. So, scattering of light is the phenomenon of change in the direction of propagation of light caused by the large number of particles present in the atmosphere is called scattering of light. This is what is known as scattering of light. Change in the direction of propagation of light. We know that normally the light have a tendency to travel in a straight line. But whenever the light is passing through an atmosphere, what happens to its direction? We are discussing about the scattering of light. So, the scattering means it is the process of change in the direction of light by the particles present in the atmosphere. The phenomenon of change in the direction of propagation of light caused by the large number of particles present in the atmosphere is called scattering of light. We know that the light always have a tendency to travel in a straight line, but this path of the light beam is undergoes some kind of deviation when it is happen, when it is strikes on the particles present in the atmosphere. In the atmosphere we have a large number of particles in the form of water drops, dust particles, gaseous molecules. All these are present in our atmosphere. So, whenever the light is strike on these particles present in the atmosphere, what happens to the path of the light beam? It undergoes change in the direction of propagation of the light. So, this phenomenon is known as scattering. So, scattering by the word, as its name implies, it is the driving off to different direction or spreading to different directions due to the large number of particles present in the atmosphere is known as scattering. For the path of the light beam is undergoes deviation when it is passing through the atmosphere due to the large number of particles present in the atmosphere. This process is known as scattering, scattering of light. Is it clear? Is it clear or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, why the scattering? Okay, all right. So the scattering of light is takes place mainly due to the large number of particles present in the atmosphere. Then can you say what are the different types of particles that present in the atmosphere? What are the different types of particles present in the atmosphere?
Dust particles.
Yes, dust particles.
Moisture.
Yes, dust particles, gaseous molecules and water molecules. Water molecules, gaseous molecules and dust particles are the different types of particles present in the atmosphere. So whenever the light gets strikes on these type of particles, their direction of propagation is changes. This process is known as scattering of light. So the scattering of light is entirely different from that of the atmospheric refraction. Some of the students have a misconception that both atmospheric refraction and scattering of light both are same. No, they are different. Atmospheric refraction is the refraction of light due to the varying optical densities of the atmosphere. And what do you mean by scattering? Scattering is a process of change the direction of propagation of light when it is strikes on a large number of particles present in the atmosphere. This is what is known as scattering of light. And by the term, means that the term scattering indicate that the driving of light into different direction. The driving of light into different direction. That is what you mean by scattering. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. Now we can discuss one of the application of scattering of light. One of the practical application of scattering of light is known as Tyndall effect. That is what we are going to discuss. The practical application of scattering of light is known as Tyndall effect. Okay, the Tyndall effect. I hope you are hear this term in chemistry class, Tyndall effect. Have you heard about this term, Tyndall effect?
Yes, ma'am.
Then can you say what do you mean by Tyndall effect?
When light passes through the
path of the light beam is visible. Spreads. Yeah, path of the light beam can be visible. I will explain it more. The Tyndall effect is nothing. It is a scattering of visible light by colloidal particles. What do you mean by colloids? Have you heard about this term, colloids?
Yes, ma'am.
Colloids. In chemistry, the solutions are mainly classified into three. What are they? In chemistry, the solutions are mainly classified into three. What are they? One is true solution. The second one is suspension. And the third one is colloids. This is the classification that we are discussed or studied in chemistry. What do you mean by true solution? What do you mean by true solution? What do you mean by true solution? Can you make a guess? Yes, Aman.
Completely dissolved.
Yes. The true solution is a mixture of solution in which the solute particles are completely dissolved. Example, we can say in the case of, can you say one example for true solution? Yes. An example for true solution. Salt solution is an example of true solution. Here the salt particles are completely dissolved in water. Then it is the result in the formation of salt solution, right? So here, can you see any particles that is floating on this water? In the case of sugar solution, can you see the salt particles are floating on the surface of water? Is it possible? No, because the salt is completely dissolved in water. Such type of solutions are known as true solution. And the second one is suspension. In the case of suspension, I will say an example. Muddy water. Have you ever observed the muddy water? Muddy water is an example for suspension. That is, initially the particles are not settled down, but when we are kept it for some times, we can see that mud is settled down at the bottom and water is in the upper part. That kind of solutions are known as suspension. Or another form, if you are mix any chalk powder in a bowl of water, what happens? For sometimes the chalk powder or the chalk particles are restless. They are in a continuous motion with the water, but when we are allowing them to rest, what happens? The chalk powder are become settled down at the bottom and water is in the upper part. So such type of solutions are known as suspension. Now the third one, that is our colloids. In the case of colloids, the particles are never settled down. They are always in a continuous motion. They are very restless, just like some class. Just like some pupils in some classes, they are very restless. They never settle down at the bottom. They are in continuous motion. So such type of solutions are known as colloids. Example, milk. Milk is a colloid because the particles present in milk are in continuous motion. Similarly, our air. Air is an example for colloid. Why? Because a large number of particles are present in our air. And these particles are never settled down. They are in continuous motion. Okay, so this is what you mean by colloids. Colloids are the solutions in which the particles are not settled down. Okay, so this is the meaning of colloids. Okay, so have you get an idea about what you mean by colloids?
Yes, ma'am.
So colloids are the solutions in which the particles are not settled down. And examples for colloids, some kinds of gels, milk, and air. Air is an example for colloid. So what do you mean by Tyndall effect? The Tyndall effect is the scattering of visible light by colloidal particles. By the term colloidal particle, we mean that the particles which are never settled down, they are in continuous motion. Such type of effect is known as Tyndall effect. It is the scattering of light which takes place by the presence of colloidal particle is known as Tyndall effect. So here we have three bottles. Can you identify the solutions present in each of them? What about this case? The first bottle. Yes, it is true solution. Very good. It is true solution. What about the second case? The second case is our suspension. Suspension. Okay, here the particles are settled down at the bottom after some times. Okay, and what about the third case? This is known as colloids. Can you see the particles here? These particles are in continuous motion. They are very restless. So whenever the beam of light is passing through the colloids, what happens? The path of the light beam is visible. This effect is known as Tyndall effect, or the scattering of light is takes place. That is, the light is spreading into different direction when it is strikes on the colloidal particles. This is what is known as Tyndall effect. The scattering of light, the scattering of visible light by the colloidal particle is known as Tyndall effect. So Tyndall effect is one of the practical application of scattering of light, and we can observe this Tyndall effect in our nature. I will show an example. Can I change the slide? So from the slide it is clear that the path of the beam is not visible in a true solution, because in true solution the particles are settled down, they are completely dissolved state. So the path of the light beam is not visible. In the case of suspension, initially the path of the light beam is visible, but when we are allowing the suspension to rest, what happens? The particles are settled down at the bottom, then the path of the beam is not visible. But in the case of colloids, the process of scattering is takes place, because in the case of colloids the particles are in restless, they are never settled down, they are in a continuous motion. So when the light is strikes on these colloidal particles, they get scattered, that is driving off or spreading to different direction. This phenomenon is known as Tyndall effect. Do you write the definition of Tyndall effect? This is what you mean by Tyndall effect. It is the scattering of visible light by colloidal particles is known as Tyndall effect. Can I change the slide? Do you have any doubt? You can ask. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we can check what is the practical life examples of Tyndall effect. Have you ever observed the dense forest? Canopy and dense forest? And did you see the light coming through the holes of the leaves of trees? Do you observe that? This is an example for Tyndall effect. So Tyndall effect can be seen in a dense forest due to the scattering of light by water droplets in the mist. Okay, so this is one example of Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect can be seen in a dense forest due to the scattering of light by water droplets in the mist. Due to the presence of water droplets in the mist, the scattering of light is occurs. So this is an example, practical life example for Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect can be seen in a dense forest due to scattering of light by water droplets in the mist. So in our air or in our atmosphere, the particles are in a continuous motion. Due to this, the light gets scattered due to the presence of this large number of particles in the atmosphere or air. So that is what is known as scattering of light. Its one application is Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is the scattering of light by the colloidal particles. Now we can say some examples for Tyndall effect from our daily life. Tyndall effect can be seen in a dense forest due to the scattering of light by the water droplets in the mist. Another application of Tyndall effect is can be seen when a light is enters a room through a small hole due to scattering of light by the dust and smoke particles. So if the dust and smoke particles are present in our room, what happens? The light undergoes a scattering. You can see this phenomenon in our room also. Whenever the light is enters through the windows or air holes, we can observe this Tyndall effect. Or you today itself, you just whenever your room is dark, you just turn on a torch light. Can you identify the path of the light beam? Is it possible to identify the path of the light beam? If you are yes, that is what is meant by the Tyndall effect. The path of the light beam is visible. Why the path of the light beam is visible? Because it is strikes or incident on the dust particles or smoke present in our room. So it gets scattered. The scattering is takes place. That is what is meant by Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect means the scattering of light by the colloidal particles. It is the scattering of light by colloidal particles. So here we are discussing about scattering and its application. One of the practical application of scattering is nothing. It is the Tyndall effect. That is the scattering of light by the colloidal particle. By the term colloidal particle, we mean that the particles which is in continuous motion, they are not settled down. They are never settled down. Okay, the restless particles. Okay, an example for colloidal particles are, or colloids are, air, milk. In the case of air, there are a large number of particles are present in the form of dust, gaseous molecules and water droplets. So whenever the light strike on these large number of particles, it driving off or spreading to different direction, that process is known as scattering. Okay. Can we move to the next topic?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now we can check what are the factors depends upon scattering of light. There were two factors are there. The two factors are depends upon the scattering of light. The first one is wavelength of the light, and the second one is size of the particle. So the phenomenon of scattering of light depends upon two factors. One is wavelength of light, and the second one is size of the particle. The phenomenon of scattering of light depends upon two factors. They are wavelength of light and size of the particle. Now, what do you think? Does all the light or all the colors have the same wavelength? Does all the colors have the same wavelength?
No, ma'am.
Which light or which color is with larger wavelength?
Red.
And which is one with least wavelength?
Violet.
Okay, very good. So here we can check how the wavelength is depends upon the scattering of light. Here, the light with larger wavelength undergoes less scattering. How? The light with larger wavelength undergoes less scattering. That is, wavelength is inversely proportional to scattering. If the wavelength increases, what happens to scattering? Does it scatter? If the wavelength increases, does it scatter or not? It is not scatter. That is, if the light or color that possesses high wavelength, then it is undergoes less scattering. So here you can see the explanation. The scattering of light depend upon the wavelength of the light. It is depends upon the wavelength of the light. Shorter the wavelength, more it will be scatter. Shorter the wavelength. If the wavelength is shorter, then more will be the scattering effect. Similarly, if more the wavelength, then less will be the scattering effect. So from this it is clear that we know that violet or blue is a light or color with shorter wavelength. It undergoes more scattering. Similarly, the red light have longer wavelength. So it undergoes lesser scattering. So scattering of light depends upon the wavelength of the light. Shorter the wavelength, more it will be scattered. Light of shorter wavelength can scatter even when it strikes an atom. You don't need to copy down this statement. Don't need to be copied down the entire statement. Only up to here. The shorter the wavelength, more light it will be scattered. More will be the scattering effect. For example, blue light has shorter wavelength, whereas the red light has longer wavelength. Okay. So from this we can conclude that if wavelength increases, what happens to scattering? Is it increase or decrease? If wavelength increases, what happens to scattering? Does it scatter?
Decreases.
Very good. Scattering decreases. Okay. If wavelength increases, scattering decreases. Can you say one example for the light with more wavelength? Light with more wavelength. Which is the light with more wavelength?
Red.
Red possesses more wavelength. But what about its scattering? It undergoes less scattering. Red undergoes less scattering. Why? Why red undergoes less scattering? Why
more
the red?
Bigger wavelength.
Yes, it is because of its higher wavelength or more wavelength. The red undergoes less scattering. Is it clear? Now, if wavelength is decreasing, if wavelength decreasing, what happens to scattering? What happens to scattering? Is it increase or decrease? Scattering increases. Very good. Scattering increases. Can you say one example for the light with less wavelength?
Violet.
Violet. Very good. Violet or blue. Both of them have low wavelength. Violet or blue. So what about the scattering of violet and blue? They have less wavelength, so they scatter more. It undergoes more scattering. So this is how the wavelength depends upon the scattering of light. So lesser the wavelength, more will be the scattering, and vice versa. Similarly, more the wavelength, lesser will be the scattering. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now we can check the second factor. What is the second factor that is depends upon the process of scattering? The first one is wavelength, and what about the second factor? Size of the particle, right? The second factor that is depends upon the scattering of light is size of the particle. Actually, the size of the particle determines the color of the light that gets scattered. The size of the particle determines the color of the light get scattered. That is what is we are going to discuss next. So the second factor that is depends upon the scattering of light is size of the particle, and the size of the particle determines the color of the light that get scattered. I think the slide is not clear, right? The first one is the size of the particles are basically classified into three. The first one is very fine particle. That is, if the particles are of small size. I will draw it again. Size of particle. The size of the particles are classified into three. The first one, the particles of very fine size, very small size. Very small sized particles. The second one, large sized particles. And the third case, if the particles are large enough, if it is very large enough. Okay. Now, if the particles are very small size, then the light with a small wavelength is get scattered. Light with small wavelength gets scattered. So can you say which light is get scattered under this condition? If the particles are very yes,
small.
Yes, if the particles are very small size, then the light with a small wavelength get scattered. So can you say which light is get scattered if the particles are very small? What is the nature of the light? What is the color of the light gets scattered?
White light.
Yes, it is scattered by violet. Violet or blue. Why? Because they have smaller wavelength. So in the atmosphere, if the particles are present in very small in size, what happens? The light with small wavelength gets scattered. That is, violet or blue light is get scattered. Now, in the atmosphere, if the particles of large size is present, what happens? The light with more wavelength is get scattered. Light with more wavelength gets scattered. Then can you say which light is scattered under this condition?
Red.
Very good. Now, if the particles are very large enough, suppose sometimes a very big sized water molecules are present in the atmosphere. So under this condition, white light is get scattered, white light. This is a exceptional condition. If very large sized particles are present in the form of water molecules in the atmosphere, during that time only the white light get scattered. So this is the second factor that depends upon the scattering of light. So the second factor that is depends upon the scattering of light is nothing, it is the size of the particle, and the size of the particle can determine the color of the light get scattered. That is, if the particles present in the atmosphere is very small, the light with a small wavelength undergoes scattering. And we know that we have a band of colors, that is we are call it as spectrum. And the spectrum is consisting of 7 colors like violet, indigo, blue, green, orange, yellow and red. Out of the 7 colors, violet or blue are the colors or the light with a smaller wavelength. So in the atmosphere, if the particles are present in very fine or very small particles are present, then the light with a small wavelength is undergoes scattering. Similarly, if in the atmosphere a large sized particles are present, then the light with more wavelength, that is red, get scattered. Red or orange, both of them have large wavelength. Now if the particles are very large enough size, suppose in some cases, in some exceptional cases, a large sized water molecules are present in the atmosphere, in that case white light is undergoes scattering. Is it clear?
Yes ma'am.
So what are the factors that is depends upon the scattering of light? What are the factors depends upon the scattering of light?
Size
of the particle. And what is the first one?
Wavelength
of light and size of the particle. So these are the two factors that is depends upon the scattering of light. Is it clear?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so once again I want to recollect all these points, after that we can move to this next. Arjun, can you say what do you mean by scattering? Okay, 1 minute. Before that, here Anne Mary asked a doubt. What do you mean by wavelength? Wavelength is nothing, it is the speed. It is the speed of the light when it is travels through a medium. Okay, the wavelength and speed both are same. Okay, is it clear? Wavelength is nothing, it is the speed of the light particle when it is travels through different medium. Okay, then where is Arjun? Okay. Arjun, what do you mean by scattering?
Spreading of light.
Spreading of light, when it is happens?
In particles.
Yes, when it is strikes on a large number of particles present in the atmosphere is known as scattering of light. Okay, good. Then Johan, can you say one of the practical life application of scattering of light? What is the practical life application of scattering of light? Johan?
Yes ma'am.
What is a practical life application of scattering of light? Yes? Nirubama? An example for the scattering of light, not Tidal effect, it is Tyndall effect. Very good, it is Tyndall effect. It's one of the practical life application of the scattering of light is Tyndall effect. Then what do you mean by Tyndall effect? Aditya, S. Krishna, all of you please switch on your video. What do you mean by Tyndall effect?
Yes ma'am.
Yes, what do you mean by Tyndall effect?
I don't.
Yes, Prajog, can you say what you mean by Tyndall effect? Why you are remaining silent? Is it not clear? Prajod Krishna. Prajod Krishna. What do you mean by Tyndall effect?
Spreading of light as it passes through light with a substance.
Yes, it is the scattering of light when it is passing through a colloidal particles. The scattering of light is occurs by the colloidal particle is known as Tyndall effect, and when the light beam is passing through a colloidal solution, it path of the light beam is visible. This is what is known as Tyndall effect, and one of the practical applications of Tyndall effect is if you are moving through a dense forest, the light is came through the holes of the leaves. It is because of Tyndall effect, and the light entering into a dark room, it is another application of Tyndall effect. Okay, then what are the factors which depends upon the phenomenon of scattering of light? Rose Sebi, what are the factors that is depends upon the scattering of light? Very good. Wavelength of light and size of the particle. Then Rifa, how the wavelength of light depends upon the scattering of particles?
Ma'am, will you repeat the question?
How the wavelength depends upon the scattering of light?
Ma'am, it's English.
Yes, whenever the wavelength is in large, if the light possesses more wavelength, what will be the scattering effect?
Many.
Scattering will be more or least?
More. Less.
Less. Less will be the scattering. So if a light possesses more wavelength, then lesser will be the scattering. Then Vishnupriya, can you say an example for the light with more wavelength?
Red light.
Red light is undergoes less scattering or more scattering?
Less scattering.
Okay, then what about the second factor that is depends upon the scattering of light?
Size of the particle.
Size of the particle. How the size of the particle is depends upon scattering of light then?
If the size is very small, then the light with less wavelength will scatter.
Okay.
If the particle is large, then light with more wavelength will scatter.
Okay. If the particles are large enough, then?
If it is large enough, white light will scatter.
White light will scatter. Okay. Students, that's all. We can discuss. We can see you on the next class. Okay. Thank you all. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.